rock.
Moment. Have a pillow. Where's your wife?
She should be here by now. I'm surprised.
Is that a noogie?
What?
A noogie. A little something she does that gets on your nerves.
Well, she's just like...
Use the bataka.
What?
Here. Whenever we encounter the noogies of this life, it's always best to deal with them in a violent and aggressive manner. Now hit the pillow and say, "Damn you!" What's your wife's name?
JD.
JD. Damn you, JD! Now say it.
I don't think
of course you don't. But you do. Inside, you do want to say it. That is the secret to a happy, healthy, mature relationship. Confront the noogies and slaughter them. Now hit the pillow and say, "Damn you, JD!"
Well, this wasn't even my idea.
She made you come to see us, is that what you're saying?
Not exactly me.
You're a little castrated, aren't you, Mark? Go with it. Let it out. Hit the pillow and say, "I do have balls."
Well, of course.
Hit the pillow, Mark. Come on, you want to save this marriage, don't you? Hit the pillow.
Look,
oh, you're afraid. Is that it? I knew it. You're a coward. You're basically a coward at bottom. You're nothing but a yellow-bellied castrated coward.
Look, why don't we wait until
angry, Mark? Is my scene that make you angry? Hit the pillow, Mark. Come on. You have balls. Hit the pillow and say, "Damn you, Tiffany." Say it. Damn you.
Damn you, Tiffany.
Damn you, JD.
Damn you, JD.
That's it. Oh, that's wonderful. You do have balls. You do have balls.
Damn you, JD.
For your pain. Does this bother you, what you just heard? Take the bataka, JD. Hit the pillow and say, "Damn you, Mark." Mark, give her the bataka.
No.
Give her the bataka. Well, don't be hurt by what she has to say.
Tell her to get her own bataka.
Mark! Remember what he said, JD. He damned you. In front of a total stranger, when he was hitting that pillow, he was hitting you. Now, what do you say to that, JD?
Damn you, Mark.
That's right, now use the bataka.
Damn you, Mark!
The pillow! Now, what seems to be the problem? You, what did you do?
No one's blaming you.
Mentally? Emotionally?
What did you do?
Did you force your big, ugly body on her when she didn't want it? Or was it just the opposite, Mark? Are you incapable of giving her the physical pleasure she so desperately needs? Admit it, Mark, you're nothing but a cold-hearted, selfish, shallow individual. Once you admit that, your relationship can be saved.
She's not usually like this all the time.
I used to have a relationship like this too. My first husband chained me to the kitchen stove. Do you believe that? I thought it was normal. I wrote my dissertation on the open door. Got a degree in marital counseling. My own personal relationship was a sham. I would have committed suicide if the stove had been gas. I try to stick my head in the microwave, but the chain wouldn't reach. Then I met Roger, and Now I realize that not all men were like the Neanderthal Hitler I live with. To some of them. But you can't be helped. Marriage must never be safe. Men like you should go to jail for what you do to women. You disgust me. Now get out of here. Get the hell out of here before you make me vomit. Get out! Get out!
Sorry, am I? Hi, welcome. I'm Dr. Roger Creosote. Welcome to Creosote Heaven. We're so sorry for your pain.
Dr. Sick, sick, sick.
I see you've met him.
Get him out of here!
This must be your lovely wife.
Roger,
did you hear
me? Oh my God.
Oh, what is she doing?
I don't know.
Of course you know. I've been waiting for months to talk to you. Why won't you answer my calls? Why won't you respond to my letters? I can't live another day without you. I only married him because I thought he had your eyes. And on our wedding night, he took them out. They were colored contact lenses. He doesn't make love the way that you do. He refuses to do it in the kitchen sink. He says nothing, it hurts his back.
Do you know this woman?
Just an old acquaintance, dude.
Roger, I love you.
JD, why did you tell me he was?
Hit me like this.
Honestly, Tiffany.
JD!
You said this whole thing out, didn't you?
You made the appointment.
JD, please.
You missed it.
I swear I didn't know.
For better or for worse, JD, remember?
Throw her out! Kick her out!
Tiffany, she's hurting.
She'll be hurting even more when I'm throwing her!
Stop!
You stay out of this!
Tiffany! Be reasonable. She has never done anything to hurt you. She's the one who suffered. I loved her for a time, and then I met you. We all know that love is a momentary and ephemeral thing. Love changes. She's got to learn that. You do too. We all do.
Why? What do you mean? What are you trying to say?
Love is a wisp on a wind. It blows here, then it blows there.
You don't love me anymore? Is that what you're trying to say? You don't love me!
Well, I wouldn't quite put it like that.
No! I can't believe this! I can't believe this nightmare!
I'm sorry, Tiffany. I'm so sorry.
I'll show you pain!
What's so cool about this?
You stay out of this!
I really can see you in my mind! What are you doing?
What? Are you jealous? Do you have this kiss, oh Roger?
God.
Well, you can't have them! No, I don't want that that you'll ever be!
No!
Leave her, Roger! Forget about me!
Yes. Run away! You were running away, him and me.
Don't you think we should
talk? You stay out of this! I'll do anything you want. I'll be the slave who chain you to the stove, and I love it!
Stop! Stop it! Stop! You're trying to make me jealous, Tiffany, aren't you? Well, it worked. But not in the way you think. I don't love you. And I don't love you, J-Dean. I don't love anybody. I'm a sad, pathetic, despicable human being. We all are. All except this man. Three of us are searching for love, and we love no one but ourselves, but this man. He's good. I sense that the minute I walked in here, he's capable of great affection, great feeling, aren't you?
Well,
I'm not! I look at a man like this, and I am consumed with jealousy. I could hate you. I could murder you.
I could tear you up into little pieces and feed you to the dogs, but you know something else?
I could also love you. No, I just said I don't love anybody. If I could love anybody, I'd love you. Yes! Oh, yes! I want to love you when I don't even know your name. I'm such a fake! I'm teaching people how to love and I don't know.
help me!
He can't do it, Roger.
I'm not that good at loving anyone myself.
He's boring. He's unimaginative.
His bigot hurts his back.
He's pathetic.
He's one big noogie.
I don't love you, Roger. No offense, but I don't love you because I can't teach you what love is.
Oh, all right. At least that's cleared up.
Leave him, Roger. He's bad for you.
He's a cold, hearted, selfish, shallow individual. He can't appreciate you, Roger.
We can love you.
We do love you, Roger. And in time, perhaps you can learn to love us
together.
Yours.
Okay, I'm leaving now. Won't be coming back, you know. It's all my fault, and I do feel guilty. I guess I just fell in love with the wrong person, right? Life goes on. Good